Virginia.
England.
Macon, Georgia.
My mother-in-law, who just died a few weeks ago, by the way, was from New Jersey. She lived in California from the time she was 13 years old, and she was 93, so she lived there a long time. Do you know that she still has her New Jersey accent when she does, as well as all her people?
What part of Joyce?
Right across New York, or whatever is there. And I actually was born in Oklahoma, but I have to tell you, England, my first ancestors came, one in 1611 to the second Jamestown colony, and the other side of the family came in about 1640, somewhere like that, and he was part of a hat-making family from Warwickshire, and his family sent the oldest son, which Henry was, over to start trading with the Indians for beaver fur, for their hat-making industry. So, you see, we all are part of the past. And the theme of my talk really is from William Faulkner, who used to live here and write some books here, when he said, the past isn't dead. The past isn't even past. And that sounds kind of puzzling until you really think about it. But it's not past. And this little baby sitting in here in this stroller is absolute proof of it, because she is as much of the past as I am, as you are, as our ancestors were. So everything continues. And this story of the city of New Orleans really is about continuing. And of course, right now, we have a hard job ahead of us to continue because of what Katrina did. But it isn't the first time that New Orleans has been wiped out by, I like to say the words that begin with F, fire, flood, fever, yellow fever especially, and Formosan termites are doing their part to take down the old city. And if you really have a sense of humor, you can even include FEMA. That's kind of an inside joke here in New Orleans. But nevertheless, we are really just the continuation of our past.